Yeah, look at that aloe, tall and skinny. Look at that one, it's so tall and skinny. I find it difficult to even get it to stand up straight. It just falls over, because look at that. Now that is an aloe. Now usually, I think of aloes, you know, a bit more, maybe like that. And then I kind of like that form. And this one's about the flower. Very nice. And I noticed that they don't all really get this nice shape. Some other types, unless they get a lot of sun, will be more like this. They're still pretty squat, but they just don't get that really nice star shape. And then if you get a little more sun, it does seem like they get more of that shape that I prefer. Though this like speckling on them makes me think it might be a slightly different variety. Nonetheless, under a lot of sun, it doesn't get really big really fast. However, this aloe here that I was referring to before, I like to call it Earl's Misbehaving Aloe. Earl Avenel, family friend, had these aloes in his house, his apartment in Washington, D.C., next to the Estonian Embassy. And I think it was the Women's Journalist Club. He lived on like the third floor. Very cool place, I have to say. In any case, these were in his apartment. And while visiting with the family, I took some cuttings of it and stuffed them in a box and shipped them to California. Thinking the only reason why they're long and spindly like that is because they're not getting enough light in the house. However, here's a little speckled one. Very similar to the speckling you see on Earl's Misbehaving Aloe. And it doesn't misbehave, really. It stays pretty stocky. You know, you can stand. The pot up. But this. He gets kind of tall. Look at how tall it gets. It just starts shooting up. Interesting aloe. I don't really like this form, I have to say. Though I like Earl, and it always reminds me of Earl, that I can never tell the difference when they're small between the one that stays kind of stocky and I prefer to the one that gets tall and skinny and is really misbehaving. And as you can see, it can really get big, but it just goes all over the place. It doesn't stand up really well. I have to lean the pots against the wall because it just gets big. Even though I did tame this one here. This one here is pretty tall and straight. So, I don't know what to say about Earl's Misbehaving Aloe. Kind of just sneaks into the cuttings when I'm trying to grow them. Like here, hey, they may show up in here. Like some cuttings in there may turn out to be Earl's Misbehaving Aloe. It will annoy me. They're kind of cool, but they don't really flower. And I'm selling them. So if you like Earl's Misbehaving Aloe, I will cut them and stick them in a box and ship them to you for $5, just like I shipped them to myself in California from Washington, D.C. It's a trailing kind of aloe. It's aloe vera. You know, if you got a burn or whatever, it does the thing. Does the job. But for me, I find it to be kind of misbehaving. Getting very top heavy. Falling over all the time. And showing up in pots where I didn't expect it to grow that way. So, if you're a fan of trailing aloe, and you like Earl's Misbehaving Aloe, then order one, and I shall ship it to you.